The attention of legislators on the Presidential Affairs Committee was drawn to 4.283 billion shillings allocated to the Vice President for Donations. To their surprise, the same amount is reflected in the current financial year budget of the entity.
You look at donation is increasing. And if you go to this, you'll see donation is increasing from 4.2. Am I seeing well?
Committee members, led by their chairperson, Jessica Ababiku, flagged the allocation as a wasteful expenditure, saying the vice president does not commit pledges on her own, but on behalf of the president, who has a fully facilitated donation budget.
Though you are not asking for more money, but members are saying this is a wasteful expenditure. So we need a proper justification of this. But if it is classified, let us also know.
We were surprised to see that the office of the vice president is also allocated donation money. And yet the practice is contrary. Normally donation goes to the office of the president.
However, Haj Yunus Kakande, who led officials from the Office of the President to defend the 2024-2025 national budget estimates, explained that there are commitments which require the Vice President to have an independent budget for donations.
There is no way that when the Vice President go to Moyo, and then there is a secondary school which needs construction, and he lack money and fails to contribute to that construction. In churches, church leaders and the Muslim leaders, they always ask for funding from the vice president's office to be helped.
Legislators questioned the expenditure of the vice president's donation budget, saying retired Major Jessica Alupo has failed to fulfill pledges she made in her constituencies on the pretext of lack of funds.
Two or three instances she has come to Sironko and even promised there's the only girls' school, secondary school called Udajil Girls. She even promised them she'll donate computers. She came back and said, I'll donate the facing of the school because it is open and the girl child and so on. But we have moved to that office several times and says, me have no money.
Vice president is under state house. So there is no way you can bring vice president in the office of the president. So it is all under state house.
The committee resolved that 4.283 billion shillings be moved to the state house's donation budget, where it can be put to proper use, although the resolution did not please some committee members.
When we get state house here, we want this to be differentiated. VP and the principal.
Much as we say it has to be moved to state house, and it is kept there, what difference will it make?
To channel the money to state house does not cure the problem of wasteful expenditure. It is a double sword. We are giving money on money, which is already there. The state house already has a budget for donation.
In the 2024-2025 budget estimates under review, the state house is seeking 30 billion shillings for presidential donations. Meanwhile, the Committee of Presidential Affairs learned from Kakande that the suspended deputy RSCC for Rubaga, Anderson Warora, is facing interdiction.
I want to inquire, the faith of the RSCC of Rubaga, the faith, what has so far been done to the RSCC who spoke derogatory messages about Parliament?
I advised him, he refused. So what I did, I suspended him. And after suspension, I'm going to take him to the Rwanda Sanctions Committee, and then we interdict him completely.
Legislators recommended for capacity building of residential district commissioners across the country to understand their mandate. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.